A new feature from Airtable now allows us to include groups inside of our filters, which gives filters a whole new layer of complexity and allows us to build better views. If you're interested in learning how to do this inside of Airtable, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth Pronovost. I'm the owner of Gap Consulting, a consulting business that helps you to organize and automate your business using no-code tools, including Airtable. So if that's of interest and you haven't already, check out the links below and explore all the different free resources that we've put together for you, including my weekly webinar. Once a week, I hop on a webinar to teach you the basic fundamentals of building automation. Now, personally, I save 20 hours per week, and a lot of my clients get similar results. So if you're interested in learning how you can leverage automation, you don't want to miss that webinar to understand the basic building blocks so that you can get started in that. Check it out below, garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. And even if you can't attend the live event, no problem, I'll send you a copy of the replay. But without further ado, let's hop into this video. We are talking about the new filter capabilities inside of Airtable. Now, in the old days, we had a very complicated way of working around an issue. Specifically, the issue is if we are looking to do ands with ors. So we're gonna have to first define what the heck I'm talking about, then I'm gonna show you the old way of doing it, and then finally, we're gonna wrap it up nicely with the new way, thanks to this new feature in Airtable. So first, let's define ands and ors, right? And simply means everything within this condition is all simultaneously true. So for an and condition to be met, everything within that has to all be true simultaneously. Now with an or condition, either of those conditions, if you have multiple conditions, any one of them has to be true in order for the overall expression to be true. Pretty straightforward, right? Standard logic. If one and two is both true, then and is true. If one or two is true, then either one of them means that the overall expression is true, right? So let's hop into an example in my Airtable base and take a look at this. Now I've got four different checkboxes here. I've grouped them into A-1, A-2, and you can see that those are orange to help us keep track of them. And then I have B-1 and B-2, okay? And so these are blue checkboxes. So let's imagine that our scenario here is an and/or statement. What we want is to filter in the records where A1 and A2 is true, or B1 and B2 is true. So you can see that this is an and statement combined with another and statement linked together with an or statement. So fairly simply put, in plain English, we would say, well, look, record 7's got A1 and A2. So that meets the first of those two conditions. Alternatively, record 8 has B1 and B2. So both of these would meet the condition, either A1 and A2 or B1 and B2, right? So how can we build this in Airtable views? Well, in the old days, we did not have this cool capability of adding a condition group. We could only add a condition. So we would add a condition that says A1 is checked and A2 is checked. Or, and now suddenly we lose it, right? We can't put an or statement here because all of the statements have to use the same logic, that is without the condition group. Now this is the new feature. So let me first show you the old workaround because I bet a lot of you had to use this in the past just in order to get this to work for you. So now that you know the right way that we can do it, you can go back, rewrite your situations and streamline it using the new and improved method, which we'll get to in a minute. So first and foremost, let's break this down. I don't want these filters. I'm gonna delete all of this. Now, first thing I have to do is build my first condition. This is gonna be group A. And I would write a formula. Remember, this is the old way of doing it. So I'd have that and statement. And A1, A2. So this means both of these things must be true. Let's go ahead and create that field and see. Now you can tell right here we've got a Boolean output. So it's either 0 or 1. It's 1 in the case where both of these things are checked off for that record. So we see that there are three instances of that. Here we go. Record 7, record 10, and record 11. Both of those orange checkboxes are showing up there. Now, similarly, we'd have to check for group B. Here's group B, write a quick formula as well. Again, this is an AND formula, right? So we'd write that AND formula in this case for B1 and B2. So in the condition where both B1 and B2 are checked off, then we're getting ones here, right? So here we are, record 8, record 9, and record 11. Pretty straightforward. Now what we can do is apply this to our filter. So we can say, well, that group A that we built, that has to be 1. Or that group B that we built, that has to also be 1, or that could also be 1. And so now what you see is out of the total of 12 records that we started with, now we're condensed to, what is this, just 5 records in the case where both A1 and A2 are checked, or B1 and B2 are both checked. And that's the exact output we wanted, but again, we had to do this extra work in order to get it to go. No longer. So let's finally take a look at the new feature that Airtable's released and build this in a grouped view, grouping our filtered conditions. So we're going to create a new view. We're going to call this one the new way. And I don't need to worry about groups A and B. I'm going to remove those from our view because it's completely irrelevant. We don't have to do the work of building those extra formulas. Now what we can do is set up our filter. And we're going to start by adding a condition group. So in condition group 1, we're going to add a condition. And this is going to be that A1 is checked, and let's hit that plus, add another condition, and A2 is checked, and we have to make sure that we toggle that to AND. All right, so far so good. This is similar to how we used to build it, except that it's built inside of a group. And now we're allowed to add another condition group, which is separate from the first group, and you see that now we can change the way that this group is relating to the first group. So essentially, we can have multiple groups that are on an or an AND statement, and the rules inside the groups can be different. And this is the new part. This is where things are getting unlocked because we couldn't do that grouping before. So now we can come in here and we can set up our second condition group. We're gonna add a condition for this group where B1 is checked, and condition 2, make sure that's an AND, B2 is checked. So just as we did before, we condensed our total number of records from 12 down to 5, and we can see here that both A1 and A2 are checked in every case, or B1 and B2 are checked. So again, flipping between the two different outputs here, we see the same records, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And again, here in the new way, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11, thereby removing the need to write those extra formulas. Now we have the ability to put this right in our grouped filters and unlock even more power within the way that we streamline the data that we see in our database view. I hope you got a ton of value out of this. If you did and you have any questions, be sure to leave them below, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.